We've got some news about Jack Collister this week, don't we?
Yeah, sad news, Chris. It's Jack's moving on. He's going back to Coldy, his old club, and it's quite emotional actually, because Jack has just been amazing for us as a player. He's been amazing for us just as a guy to have in and around the club. He's much loved and adored by fellow players, staff, supporters, vice presidents, etc. And he's also a friend. He'll obviously carry on being a friend. I'm sure we'll get a bit of golfing together in his ridiculously bright yellow trousers over the summer. But he's just been brilliant for us. But you know, his game time has been limited here, and you know, we have to sort of be honest in, you know, what he can expect. And Jack thrives from playing regular games. His family are over from the Coldy way as well, so he just feels that it makes sense. We would have loved to have kept him, and as I say, you know, he's just had a huge impact on our club. It's very hard for a non-student to come into a student environment, and Jack's managed that process really well and probably changed a lot of opinions and attitudes with regard to non-students coming into the environment as well. So we feel that we've had a positive influence in Jack, and we absolutely know that he's had a very positive influence on Loughborough Students Rugby Club, and we thank him for that.
And we're starting the build-up for Hadean's testimonial game at the end of the season. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, just firstly, hugely deserved. It's Hadean's 20th year involved with the club this year, which is absolutely staggering. You know, he never asked for any expenses or money. It's just purely he loves doing the job. He loves working with young people, being a mentor, being a manager, being a coach, and seeing those guys develop. And you know, I know since my time at Loughborough, Hayes has been invaluable in terms of the help and advice and guidance that he's given. And putting this game on, I think it's just going to be a great celebration of Hayes' 20th year involved with the club, and I know we'll see a lot of alumni up here who are going to have very fond memories of Hadean, and want to repay that by attending and supporting the event.
And going back to the here and now, we had a good result on Saturday. What were your thoughts on that game?
Well, just a good day in general, Chris. I mean, it's great having the first and seconds playing, and the twos had a really good win against Wharfedale. I'd like to thank Wharfedale for bringing their twos down. We really enjoyed taking our guys up to Wharfedale earlier on in the season. With regard to the first 15 game, a valuable 5 points, and I think everyone in the setup was quite aware that, you know, if we'd sort of lost that game and then we're going down Sinford this week, we, you know, potentially would have been feeling a little bit more pressure than we are now. And that win has now enabled us, I think, to hopefully sort of release the shackles a little bit. And we've been challenging the players this week that we're in a good, confident place. We've won our last 3 home games, and it's not about complacency. It's now actually about getting really excited about where we can take our game, which is developing quite nicely at the moment. So really, really pleased. And there was good balance to our game as well in terms of what we put out and how that put stress on Wharfedale.
And the second half performance was obviously particularly good. We kept them scoreless in the second half and came from behind at half time.
Yeah, I think the defence really stepped up in the second half. We defended multiple phases, and we were actually driving Bladen back, and Kieran's did quite a lot of work during in the week of actually coming off the line hard and straight, especially close to our line, and I think that showed. And we also just worked on a few things which, you know, we would change about our game going into the second half, which we felt would bring us success, and it did. So it's good to see all the hard work by the coaches and the boys during the week paid off in the game.
And what are your hopes for the Cinderford game coming up?
To win. Yeah, I mean, I almost get sort of bored of saying this, but you know, we just know the league is so competitive, and Cinderford beat Ealing at their place a few weeks ago. They're fighting for their lives to stay in National One, as we are, as a, you know, probably you could say all the teams, you know, up till 7th place are in theory. So we've just got to make sure we bring our game on Saturday and defend as well as we did in the second half against Wharfedale.
Thank you.
Thanks.
box twos against box threes this week. What are your thoughts on it?
Really looking forward to it. I think the games sort of between book sides internally are always interesting. There's an added bit of sort of spice and motivation. I remember sort of my time here as a player playing in one of the games, and it was a real sort of highlight. So looking forward to seeing the two sort of teams go at it tomorrow. Lots of sort of competition for places, so it'll be a good way for us as coaches, managers to kind of gauge where people are at. But hopefully just a really good spectacle that those not involved can get down and watch. And having watched the Bucks 3 play last week, they look really, really sharp. So I think the Bucks 2s are probably going to have a real tough afternoon, so they'll need to be playing well to get a result there.
And we're just in the process of setting up the Hayden game for the alumni coming up. Can you tell us a bit more about that?
Yeah, Hayden's, for you know, most people watching will probably know Hayden. Hayden's been involved in the club now for what is his 20th season. Fantastic sort of service to the club. I remember Hayden's when I was a student here, sort of being great at that time. Still here now as I've come back as a member of staff, and you know, does some really fantastic work in terms of on field, in his manager role, making sure that everybody's got everything they need, and then off field in terms of just being a really good sort of mentor and somebody for the guys to speak to, whether that's coaches or managers or players. So he's been a fantastic servant. I think it's you know, a great opportunity for us to put on a bit of a show for him with the alumni game. That's going to happen on Saturday the 9th of May, so we're looking for a really strong alumni team to play against the full first team. Hopefully have a function afterwards then with a presentation for Hayden's and make it a really good event. There'll be some further details coming out about the game on our news page. Opportunity for alumni, whether they're interested in playing or whether they're just interested in coming along for the day and having a bit of a catch up. All the details will go up over the next week or so on the website. But we're just hoping for a cracking day as a way to recognise Hayden's service to the club.
And have you got any plans for Valentine's Day?
Well, Valentine's Day falls on Saturday when we've got Cinderford away, so yeah. I'll be enjoying the Forest of Dean for the day, then probably quite late when we get back. But on the Sunday, got a little cinema trip to watch 50 Shades of Grey, so yeah, looking forward to that.
Thank you. Win on the weekend against Wharfdale, what did you make of it?
Brilliant win at the weekend. Really targeted that game. They were just above us. We've managed to leapfrog them now. We know what a good team they are as well. They've had some great results in the league so far. So we really had to play to our best to get a result against them. And we did do that. Whether they, I thought, contributed massively to the game as well. So I just thought it was a great game of rugby for neutrals as well. Some great tries from us. Dave's probably touched on it, but stuff we've all worked on during the week. And defensively, getting back to our ways that we're good at, and defending for massive periods of play, which for me was great. And actually knocked them backwards, which is what we're all about. So delighted with that win, and a good win for the twos as well. So just a good day all round.
And we've got box twos v threes this week. Are you looking forward to that one?
Definitely. Really looking forward to it. However, I'll not be there. I'm on a course. Unfortunately, I'm absolutely gutted. I'm trying to get out of it. But there's been some spice around this one. I've been winding Gerard Mullen, the box two coach, up for quite a while about this, because he's went unbeaten so far. But I think they could find this one really tough. So. Really looking forward to that, and I can't wait to hear how that one goes.
And what are your plans for Valentine's Day?
Well, with the wee one kicking about, it'll not be much. We'll be lucky if we get a takeaway or anything like that. Maybe head out for some Sunday lunch on Sunday, but no, I think we'll be very quiet and babysitting. That'll be about it.
Thank you. So we've got the box twos against box threes coming up. What are your hopes for that game?
Yeah, it should be good. Looking forward to it. I think both teams are taking it very seriously. Both sets of coaches are taking it very seriously. I know Mitch had the box threes out the other night, scrummaging for about 5 hours. So, they're very keen to win, both sets of them. So, I think for us, as the box ones guys, we're looking to see who can possibly step up. Perhaps this year, maybe a little bit too late, but certainly next year, there's quite a few freshers in those two teams. So we'll be along just to see what sort of potential we've got for next year. Really looking forward to it.
And what's going on in the Chuter household for Valentine's Day?
Very little, actually. believe it or not, I'm not a romantic. We've got the kids are doing stuff on Saturday, and it's quite sort of sort of novelty's worn off after being married for about 15 years. We'll probably have a bit of a drink in the evening together, and watch something boring on TV. That's about it, really. Maybe I'll sing some songs like Aladdin to her, and that's it, really.
Thank you.